Let's talk about Excel's best and easiest lookup function, XLOOKUP. In this quick video, you're going to get a snapshot of what XLOOKUP can do for you and how you can apply it to solve different lookup problems. If you're excited about this, hit that thumbs up. To check for availability of this function, check out the description below. I'm also going to talk about it at the end, so stay with me.
Here's your challenge. You have a list of people working in your project team and their yearly salary. You need to figure out their division and their bonus scheme. You get a list from HR, which you put in a separate tab, which includes the start date, division, department, and the name of the employees. Right here, you have the bonus scheme. Based on this information, let's start to figure out the division of the people. Start off with XLOOKUP. First argument is the lookup value. What are we looking for? We're looking for this name right here. Next argument is the lookup array. This is the list where we're looking up this name in, which has to be a list that includes the names, which is sitting right here. So control shift down to highlight everything. Press F4 to fix it because I'm planning to pull down the formula. Or if you don't want to worry about the referencing, just turn this data set into an official Excel table. Now the next required argument is the return array. What do we want returned? We want the division. It's sitting right here, control shift down, press F4 to fix it, and that's it. The next two arguments are optional and we don't need it because guess what? The default match type is an exact match. So we don't have to add anything more to this formula. That's it. Press enter and we send this down. Let's just double check. Natalie Porter should work in the productivity division. We have Natalie Porter right here in the productivity division. Since XLOOKUP requires the lookup array and the return array separately, it doesn't matter where the return array is. It could be on the left-hand side of the lookup area or the right-hand side. Both directions will work fine. Now, let's take a look at something here. We have Kim West working for the utility division. But do they really work for utility? Let's take a look. Kim West is sitting right here, utility, but Kim West is also sitting down here and is working for the game division. So they have a second start date. They first started in the utility division in 2014 and then moved on to the game division in 2018. How could we get their last division? We just have to add an argument to our XLOOKUP. Let's copy this formula, paste it right here, and take a look at the other arguments that we have. The fourth argument is the match mode. Default is an exact match, so we don't have to worry about putting a zero in there. We'll take a look at this one when we get the bonus number, and wildcard is a good one if you don't have the full name. For the purpose of getting the current division, I'm looking for an exact match, so I can put a zero or I just skip this argument. This is the one that I need to change. It's the search mode. So default is one, it searches first to last, which means it finds the first occurrence of the lookup value and it gives back the result. But you can also search last to first. So this is what I need in this case because I want to find the last occurrence since my data is sorted by the start date. And now I get the last division they worked in. And check this out, Stevie Bridge has also changed division from game to utility. Now let's calculate the bonus. Let's start off with XLOOKUP, lookup value. This time we only care about the salary of the person. Lookup array, where are we looking up the salary in? Well, we have the salary scheme right here. This is where we need to compare the actual salary with the scheme. I'm going to fix this. Now for the next argument, we want the return array. We want to get the bonus percentage. Let's fix this as well using the F4 key. Now for the match mode, this is something I need to change because exact match is not really going to give me the results. I need to go with -1 to get the next smaller item. I can leave search mode out of this, close bracket, press enter, and I have my number. Just send this down. Now check this out. Kim West earns 60,200. Anyone earning a salary between 60K and 100K will get a 10% bonus. Now, instead of -1, if I had picked 1, it will show me 15%, which is the next one. But in this case, I'm going to go with minus one. Now, here's another great thing about the XLOOKUP function. It doesn't care about the sorting of this data. Now, logically, you would sort this because it's easier to read. But if this was sorted the other way around, the XLOOKUP formula is not going to break. Now, even if this was sorted in a messy way, so if I take this 100,000 and drag it and drop it between these, it's not going to break. It's still going to work. So forget about using VLOOKUP in these cases. You can now use XLOOKUP. There's a lot of potential in this function. We're going to dig deeper in future videos.
That's a quick overview of XLOOKUP. What do you think? Can you think of some of your spreadsheets where you can apply this to? If you're a big VLOOKUP user, you've probably noticed some of the advantages of XLOOKUP. It had no problem looking up values from either side, so from left or right. And to look for an exact match, we didn't need to specify anything. Exact match is the default. We also get the chance now to return the last match instead of the first one. And guess what? XLOOKUP can do horizontal lookups, so we can forget about using HLOOKUP. All of these benefits packaged nicely in one single function. Now, this is brand new, so it's currently only available for Office 365 insiders and hopefully soon for everyone using Excel for Office 365. I hope you enjoyed this video. And before you leave, if you haven't already subscribed to this channel, make sure you do so and hit that bell so you get updates when I put out new videos here.